In the previous lecture, we saw that suppose we are given vector bundles. E and F over Y, and let's say an map alpha between them, and F from X to Y is a smooth map. Then we obtain vector bundles F upper star E, F upper star F, and a map of vector bundles F upper star alpha. So in particular, we may So, in particular, a global section of F pulls back to a global section of F of plus star. So, let's continue with some observations related to vector bundles. So suppose we are given a diagram and as always theta is smooth, g to x and f to y are vector bundles, and theta from g of the fiber over p to f of p is linear. Then the map theta factors as G to F upper star F So let us see how to do this. First, we may cover Y by open sets VIs, let's say VJs, J in semantic sense of J, such that F restricted to each VJ is trivial. And then, so we may also cover X by open sets. We may write so X by open sets, the I in semantic sense set I, UI, such that G restricted to UI is trivial. And these UIs, they have the property that F of UI is contained in VJ for some J. So by increasing by increasing the index set. J, we may assume that there is an index set I such that X is equal to union I in I UI, Y is equal to union I in I VI, F is trivial on VI, G is trivial on UI, and F of UI is contained in VI. So notice that, note that it may happen that VI is equal to VI prime for distinct I and I prime. So now consider the diagram. G restricted to UI. F restricted to VI. Let us assume that F has rank M and G has rank N. So this diagram will imply that theta is a smooth map from UI to M cross N matrices. So it's precisely given by theta of X is equal to the, so we can choose a trivialization. And theta x is the matrix which sends, yeah, theta x is the linear map from x cross Rn to x cross Rn. So consider the following general assertion. Suppose e to x is a vector bundle trivial on open sets UI and glued using transition functions phi ij's from uij to gl and r. Suppose wi is contained in ui and these cover x, then we may glue the trivial bundles on WI using phi ij's from WIJ to GLNR. So the both these bundles are isomorphic. This is left as an exercise. So we apply this general observation to the bundle F upper star F. So this is trivial. On UIs, which are contained inside, it's also trivial on this is trivial on UIs. Well, it's trivial on F inverse VI. And UIs are contained in F inverse VI, and so trivial on UI, and moreover, X is the union of UIs. So to define. A map from G to F upper star F, a map of bundles, we will define it on UI and check that these glue together. On UI, define UI cross RN to UI cross RM x comma lambda maps to x comma theta of x lambda. For these maps to glue, the condition we need is theta j x compose phi I j x is equal to psi I j of f of x composed theta I of x. But this holds by comparing theta in the two trivializations and it is easy to see that the composite is theta. simply check locally using definitions. One situation, we can apply this to is and then we get a map of bundles over X. Now let's return to a generality on bundles. Suppose we have a map of bundles on X. Then we get a map theta dual as follows. So theta dual is from F dual. So we may cover X by opensets UI such that E and F restricted to UI are trivial. And theta restricted to UI is given by maps theta i's from UI to M cross N matrices. Then one easily checks that the maps theta I transpose from UI to N cross M matrices defines a map. The map theta I transpose will also glue to define a map from F dual to E dual. So recall that if E is defined using transition functions, phi ij's from uij to glnr, then E dual is defined using transition functions phi ij transpose inverse. This implies for a smooth map, F from X to Y, we get a map of bundles F upper star omega Y to omega X. Moreover, on each fiber, this map is dual to the map on the fibers But this fiber is isomorphic to T by F of P, and this map we know is DF at P. So that is the map omega y at P, which is isomorphic to P to omega x at P, is exactly equal to DF at P and the dual of that. So having made this observation, let us once again return to some generalities. Next, we claim that there are natural isomorphisms F upper star F F upper star of the Rth symmetric product is isomorphic to the Rth symmetric of F upper star F, and similarly for the exterior. The necessary observation here is the following. Let V be a vector space and suppose we are given a smooth map phi from U to odd V. Also assume that we are given a smooth map F from W to U. Then we get phi compose F from W to odd V using this we have phi tensor R compose F, this from W to odd V tensor R, and we also have phi compose F tensor R, again from W to odd V tensor R, and both these are equal. Similarly, we have okay, so maybe I should write this as SR of phi compose F And finally, we have the same thing for the exterior. So using all these observations, one deduces the same assertions about bundles. In the usual way. This is left as an exercise to the reader. We will apply these to smooth maps f from x to y. Our aim is to show that there is a map of complexes. Says that all these squares commute. This will induce a map on. This will induce a map on cohomology. Which we denote F upper star. So let us first see, so what is the map from the ith exterior, from global sections of the ith exterior to global sections of the ith exterior. We already saw that F induces a map from F upper star omega y to omega x. This in turn induces a map of vector bundles . We can take the ith exterior omega y . But this we know is isomorphic to f upper star of the ith exterior of omega y . Thus given a section of the ith exterior of omega y, we get a section for x of f upper star at exterior of omega y. This is equal to, this gives a section of this bundle. And if we call this map A, then we can just compose with A to get a section of the ith exterior fix. So it only remains to check that with this definition, the diagram commutes. Since the differentials are defined locally, it suffices to do this check locally. That is, let be a coordinate open set and let u x1 to xn in x be a coordinate open set. Such that f of u is contained in V. Then it suffices to check that the diagram so you know gamma x gamma u commutes. Further, by linearity, it suffices to check that to check for sections on sections of the type G, T, Y, J. Let us first understand the map. The map at the level of one forms, that is the map so this map is defined as the composite. Comma V. So I take one forms on V, I pull them back, and then I apply the map. And then I apply the map, which is the map, which is from F upper star omega V to omega U. The bundle is trivial and a trivialization is given by the sections dy1, dy2, so on up to dym. Now one checks easily that the composite map is given by is given as follows. So every section S in gamma V omega V can be written as a column of m functions, so G1 up to Gm. So this represents the section summation Gi dyi. The image of S in gamma U omega U is the section DF dual applied on the vector G1 compose F to GM compose F. In other words, the image of S is the section which sends P to summation of I GI of F of P DF at P dual applied to dyi at F of P. And this is equal to I GI of F of P. We can write this as T of YI compose F since the map. Gamma V exterior omega V2 gamma U exterior omega U is induced by the map gamma V omega V 2 gamma U omega U. The induced map is given by G times T Y sub J maps to G compose F T Y J 1 compose F, which T Y J I compose F. Therefore, we need to check that. So we start with G, D, Y, J. This gets mapped to T sub V of T of G, D, Y, J. This gets mapped to a certain expression. Let us call that B. On the other hand, this gets mapped to G compose F T F J 1 which T F sub J I, which gets mapped to T U of G compose F which T F J 1 which T F J I. And the question is this expression B equal to this thing? So D sub V of G DYJ is obviously equal to DG which DYJ. And this clearly we know gets mapped to DG compose F which D F J 1 which D F J I. This implies the diagram commutes. Thus we get a map of complexes. And so on. And all these squares commute, which implies we get F upper star from H star Y R to star. Finally, let's make a comment on functoriality of pullback. If we have smooth maps and G and E is a bundle on Z, then it is immediate from the definition that G compose F upper star E is isomorphic to F upper star of G upper star E. We have maps of bundles. Alpha on X, beta on Y, and again gamma on X. Then one checks easily. That F upper star beta compose with alpha is equal to gamma. Using this, we get that the maps at the level of one forms satisfies thus the same holds for the ith exterior. This functoriality descends to cohomology. To give in particular, this shows that if F is a diffeomorphism, then F upper star is an isomorphism.